Okay, so before we get started, I just need to say really quickly that for those of you who have listening devices, the translation devices, channel 3 is Japanese, channel 4 is English, and make sure that when you leave the room, give them to the staff outside the room. There's a box where you can return the devices. Okay, so the next presentation is Running Containerized Workloads in Lattice by Eterno Gwen.
Okay, so maybe this one. Okay, so good afternoon, everyone. So before starting this talk, I want to know how many people know about Docker? Please raise your hand. Okay, that's pretty everyone. And how many of you already heard about Cloud Foundry? Okay, good. Okay, so again, this talk. Okay. So again, this talk is a beginner talk, so I will not go too deeply into the technical details. So let's start. So just quick introduction. So my name is Eterno Gwen, and yeah, I'm French. So sorry for the English listeners and the translators, but I have a big French accent. I am working in a company called Pivotal as a solution architect. This is the same company as Casey. He made a presentation yesterday about the remote working. It was pretty great, thank you. And before I was working in Lakuten, I was leading the platform team. So just a very small word about Pivotal. So Pivotal is the company behind the Spring Framework, RabbitMQ, Cloud Foundry, Pivotal Tracker, and many, many things. So this is today's agenda. So first, before talking about Lattice, so Lattice is the subset of Cloud Foundry, right? So first I will talk about Cloud Foundry. So Cloud Foundry is the platform of services. Basically, it's the platform where you deploy your application without taking care of the underlying infrastructures, or you will get many out-of-the-box things, many features, right? So Cloud Foundry is the truly open source platform of services. So that means everyone in this room can contribute to it. So again, as an open source, there is a huge community behind that. As I said, there is a lot of strong features like strong authentication, services, high availability, and of course, Cloud Foundry supports both the build pack from Heroku and Docker image as well. So, pretty basically, this is how the thing is doing in Cloud Foundry. You push your application into the system, into Cloud Foundry, and your application gets deployed. And you can access to your application. That's very simplistic, but yeah, basically it's that. So this is the Cloud Foundry architectures, I mean mostly, like 80%. And as I say, Lattice is the subset of Cloud Foundry. So basically, these are the Lattice architectures, and as you can see, we keep the logs layers, the routing layers, and we keep the schedulers, and the name of the scheduler is Diego, so I will explain about Diego later. But I know some people don't really like this kind of diagram, so to be simple, this is Cloud Foundry. And this is Lattice, right? So you can still kill people, but you have less function. OK, so why Pivotal develop Lattice? Why we choose to create Lattice? So because, I mean, Cloud Foundry is hard to install. When I say hard, it's not really technically, but there is a lot of features you don't need. And you need to create manifests, et cetera, to deploy Cloud Foundry. So it's just too much for development. So we wanted something where the developers can focus on development without wasting time of installing, setting things on their local environment. So yeah, basically something easy to use and install, and of course still be able to run Buildpack and Docker image and even your own workload. I will explain after that. But as you may know, actually, there is kind of pretty famous architectures coming up or pattern called microservices. And Lattice, as well as Cloud Foundry, will help you to run this kind of workload. But there is some situation where you could not use Lattice. So again, Lattice is focused on local development or development. So you should not use Lattice for production. Lattice don't support persistent data. Of course, you can use you can put MongoDB in Lattice, but every time it will restart, you will lose the data. Okay. And if you need strong security policy, again, like for production environment or something like that, you should not use Lattice. Okay. So Lattice is mainly used for your local environment. So for all of that, you can use Cloud Foundry. So of course, there is other solution. Like you have the do-it-yourself. Basically, you install everything by yourself. You set up everything by yourself. You have Docker. But again, there is no self-healing, no load balancing, or log aggregation. So you need to set up these features around Docker. And you have Kubernetes and Docker. So yeah, Kubernetes is pretty nice, but you will get, but as Casey said yesterday, Kubernetes is just a scheduler, it's not a pass. So for example, if you want a load balancing, you need to set up Nginx, et cetera, et cetera. So in Lattice, load balancing, self-healing, scheduling is already there. It's out of the box, so you have nothing to do. So now, let's check what you can do and how you can do with Lattice. So at the beginning, I say it's very easy to install Lattice, right? So yeah, I mean, it's easy. You just need to use Vagrant and run Vagrant up. That's all. And you can already start to deploy your application. You have nothing to do more. But let's say now you have 3 or 4 developers and you want to share the same environment. Or you want to put Lattice in your public or private cloud. So you can use the clusters version of Lattice. It's pretty simple. Just Terraform apply. So actually, OpenStack, AWS, and DigitalOcean are supported, but if you want to add the support for vSphere, you can contribute to Lattice. Every pull request are welcome. So now we'll talk about the scheduling, because I think it's an important part of Lattice. So this, as I already shared, the scheduler name is Diego. And of course, as a scheduler, it will take care of the distribution of your workload across the clusters. So Diego use an auction algorithm. And for example, Kubernetes use the bin packing one. But for Cloud Foundry, we decide to use the auction one. So two important things for Diego. Actually, Diego understands two things, a task, which is guaranteed to run once, and what we call the long running process, which can run forever, can have multiple instances, and of course, should resist against crash, network failure, etc. So quick example of task, you have the cron, or when you need to make a database migration, is just one task, right? you have the long reading process, so basically a website or some workers and database or key value stores. That's the thing you need to run forever. So now we'll explain a little bit the, and quickly the auction system. So as I see, it's an auction system. So you need to win the bids. And for that, we calculate the scores of your cells, that means where your application will run. And this score is based on the memory, disk space, the number of running containers, and the number of the same running application instances running on these cells. And the lowest scores win the bid. So I made a small animation. So as you can see, I have one instances of the blue application running, blue application I want to place, and two of the green application instances I want to place on my clusters, on what I call the cells. Okay? So the first round is pretty easy. We have an empty cell with the score zero. So yeah, basically, that this application will go there. As you can see, now the score increases, and especially the score where there is already a green application running instances, because for HA, we want to avoid the same application instances running on the same cells. So what we'll do, so this one will go to this one, because I have only a blue one, a lot of resources, and no green. And for the next one, yeah, I mean, I have two choices, but again, because the HA features is more important, it will go to the one where there is no green one. And that's all. All my application instances are placed. So now, about the self-healings. So Diego is a state machine. So that means he's always trying to keep the actual state equals the desired state. So basically, he's always calculating the delta between the actual and desired state. So again, small animation. I have six blue, I wanted to run six blue application instances, right? And actually, six are running, right? But let's say I lost the cells. So now the delta is minus three. So that means I have three application instances missing. So Diego will just reschedule these instances to another cell. And in case you don't have enough resources, Diego will keep trying to place these resources until you add new resources. As I say, you have the load balancing, so that's pretty easy. Every time you deploy or you scale new instances of your application, these instances will get registered to what we call the routers, and you will be able to access in the load balancing mode through your application URL, right? Sorry. So again, you don't need to set up Nginx, HAProxy, whatever. So the log stream and aggregation is mostly the same things. Every time you add new resources, new instances, we will aggregate the logs for the same application, and you will be able to stream it to your terminal. So some quick usage. So if you want to deploy a Docker image, that's pretty easy. LTC create your application name and the Docker image name. You can use private repository and private registry. Of course, you can set up a lot of options, memory, number of instances, disk limit. If you need to scale your application, yeah, that's pretty straightforward. LTC scale your application and the number of instances you want. For the build pack, you have two steps. The first one is we need to build what we call a droplet. So basically, a droplet is your application and the runtime, and we just merge that And when you have this droplet, we just need to run it after that. So you have only two commands. You can, of course, create your own workload. So basically, you can define a JSON file. For example, this one, I want 128 megabytes of memory. For my rootfs, I want to use, I don't know, Docker, Cloud Foundry. I mean, you can use whatever you want. And you can say which action you want to do, like run this application, et cetera, et cetera. So you can even do that with Lattice. About the routing layers, by default, all instances will go to your application name.domain.net, but of course, you can change this route. For example, in this example, I say, I want everything coming to the 8080 port of my containers or my application going to the my FNAP upset domain, right? And that's pretty easy. And for the logs, yeah, again, pretty obvious, LTC logs, your application name. So before the demo, I just want to introduce X-Ray. So X-Ray is a tool, kind of dashboard, where you can visualize your application instances. You can see the start, stop, and crash event, and you can filter by memory or containers. And of course, as all pivotal products, X-Ray is open source. So this is what X-Ray looks like. You have a lot of, you have eight cells in two distributed zones, zone one, zone two. And you have some containers using a lot of memory, some other containers using small memory. So yeah, X-Ray is pretty nice if you want to visualize what's happening in your lattice. Okay, so we make a small demo. I mean, at least I will try. Okay, sometimes some networking problems, so. Okay, so basically I will deploy, sorry, but yeah, that happens. Yeah, as I say, sometimes when I use XIP data, I get some problem, but. I will deploy a PHP application and this PHP application in a MongoDB database. So first, I will create the MongoDB database. Create. Okay, here. Hopefully, it should work. Yeah, it can take some time. Okay. Let's wait a little bit. Oh. Now again, I get the same errors. I'm pretty unlucky. So again, it don't use persistent files, so that means if I restart Lattice, I will lose my MongoDB database. Okay, now it's starting, so. Here you have X-Ray, and as you can see, my MongoDB database is starting, and I have only one instances. So let's start. It should start to run. Of course, if I do that, it will not work because I tried to access to TCP port through HTTP. Yeah, just 2 minutes. So as you can see now, it's running. So I will just start my PHP application. Okay. So hopefully it should start too. Yes, let's wait. Yeah, because basically Lattice is downloading the Docker image. So you can use local registry, etc. So yeah, application already been started. So as you can see here. And this application uses more memory than MyMongoDB. So that's why it's bigger there. And normally, if I go there, what's happened? Connection issues. Okay. It should be okay. So yeah, I mean, I missed the. Oh, yeah. Yeah, you know, sometimes things just doesn't work. Come on, start. Okay, I'm very unlucky, sorry. Just time out. But I promise you it works if you have a good network. Or if you don't use xip.io. I think maybe I can start to take some questions during the. Okay, anyway, that's the end of the presentation. I will take some questions, and hopefully during this time, application will start.
So can you put this on so we can answer these questions?
Wait.
Okay, anybody have questions? Oh, sorry. Oh. Anyone have questions? Japanese is fine.
Okay, it works. So.
Thank you for your talk. Okay. Can you explain what went wrong and how it got fixed just now?
Okay. Thank you for the questions.
Can you repeat the question?
Yeah. So, Casey wanted me to explain what was wrong and how I fixed it. So basically, I think the problem is, again, I'm using xip.io, and that means even if my lattice is locally, I still need to use the DNS outside. So sometimes it just time out. So what I did, I just remove it and restart it. That's all. It's okay?
Thank you. Pleasure. Any more questions?
Whoa.
So can we use Lattice for production in future? You said it's only for Docker development.
Actually, that's not the goals of Lattice. Again, for production, you should use Cloud Foundry. I mean, yeah, you already know Cloud Foundry, right? So yeah, Lattice is very focused for development, and I think it will stay for development. But again, I'm not the product manager, so. But that's just my guess. We keep running. But again, Lattice use most of the things from Cloud Foundry, right? So that means when you use Cloud Foundry, there will no you will not have different experiences. It will be the same. Mm-hmm. What will be able to run in Lattice will be able to run in Cloud Foundry in the same way. Just the command line change, but that's all. Thank you, Daisy.
Any more questions? Okay, if not, then I'd like to ask you to give a round of applause for the speaker.
Thank you.